Hello, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval, and this is the Solo Negocios video blog with the Solo Negocios bulletin summary for today, June 19, 2018. And today the peso got appreciated, given a single element and even a mention, simply a declaration from President Trump of the United States that they are seeking for negotiation over NAFTA. So this made a whole day for the peso, even against a whole lot of other elements, and mainly the trade war that could made it go depreciated. Well, the appreciation got in only 0.01% to 20 pesos with 51.75 cents per dollar, and the element that helped was NAFTA. Trade war escalated today, given new threats between China and the US of new sanctions or tariffs among them, and this is increasing pressures over capital outflows that are seeking for safe havens such as US bonds, US dollar, yen, and Swiss franc. And the trade conflict that is implying that the economy could slow down in the near future when it was a good year, or as expected, a good year. Europe already mentioned last week, specifically the European Central Bank, that they are decelerating during this year and the following 2 years. China already stated no movement on their interest rate last week also from their central bank, implying that there's just a deceleration that preoccupies them, and that's why they are not moving the rate. Now, if this trade war keeps going on, and it's not only with China, but European Union, Canada, and Mexico, among others, obviously there will be conflicts for the whole economy growth in the world, and also being parallel to an inflationary trend given these tariffs. Well, this is the scenario for that part, which was negative, and the Bloomberg dollar spot increased 0.25%, a great increase given specifically this seek for safe havens such as US bonds. Oil went down. Everything is under expectations for Friday's declaration of OPEC, if they will, as is expected, begin cutting the, let's say, production cut agreement that they made last year. The support is 20 pesos with 20 cents, and resistance is 21 pesos per dollar in the wholesale market. Spread, specifically for banks, 1.13 pesos, which implies an increase of 0.01 peso, and it's compared to yesterday. The future market decreased 0.19% for December this year, which implies an improvement given this 3-day scenario for appreciation for the Mexican peso. But the linear trend for the following 30 days and the following 12 months for the interbank exchange rate, it's negative, so no good. In terms of monetary policy, it was a monetary policy week last week, but for developed countries. This week will be for emerging markets like Mexico and other five central banks, and also the Bank of England. Well, almost all of them will keep the rate without movement, besides possibly Mexico and Philippines. Specifically for Mexico, the issue is, or the alternative is to increase the rate, to increase hedge coverages or exchanges, and sell US dollars that we have in international reserves. Now, the scenario for sale of dollars is not pretty good. At least it has not worked in the past times that we have used it, like until December 2016 and even February 2017. The increase of the interest rate brings a risk that it will slow down our already slowed economy, given the increasing cost of money. But the increasing hedges could help without touching those negative other elements. We'll see how they react. There's a specific element to be considered. It says, it is being said that the spread, not in the banking system as we measure it, but in the interbanking system, it offsets the spread between sell and buy. So regularly, when the bank intervenes with the increase in the rate, the spread is around 5 cents. Nowadays it's 2 cents. So this brings the idea that maybe the bank will not increase the rate, because even with the high volatility in the markets, the spread is low. So this could bring the idea that it's not the moment to intervene with a hike in the interest rate of the Mexican interest, Banco de Mexico interest rate. Well, this is the information we have for today. We'll keep under the monetary scheme and information during the week, and we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you very much for your attention.